Hello all, it is Dr. Alsip here, and we are going to discuss the muscles we need to identify for the parotid gland and submandibular triangle session. These are mostly suprahyoid muscles, so those muscles above or superior to the hyoid, with an extrinsic tongue muscle thrown in there for good measure. So let's get started. So we're looking at a lateral view, kind of inferior lateral, and you will see the base of the mandible right here, and portions of the hyoid bone right here with a lot of connective tissue associated with it. And we're gonna focus on this suprahyoid region here. And one of the most dominant muscles in this area is the digastric. And in this view, you can really see both the anterior as well as the posterior portions of, or posterior bellies, excuse me, of the digastric muscle connected by this intermediate tendon right here. So you can see that it's a fairly long muscle. The anterior belly is going to attach to the mandible, which you can see it heading in that direction, with the posterior belly being attached all the way to the mastoid notch of the temporal bone. The intermediate tendon is anchored to the hyoid bone via a fibrous loop, which you can't really see very well here. And recall that the formation of these bellies are unique in that they are going to be developed through two different pharyngeal arches. So each belly has a separate innervation, which is quite unique. The anterior belly is innervated by the nerve to mylohyoid, which is a branch of V3. Whereas the posterior belly is going to be innervated by the facial nerve. So that's something that we love to talk about. Anytime that you have something unique like that, or two separate innervations, or an innervation that's different from the rest of the surrounding muscles, that's something that you'll hear us often talk about. Returning to the intermediate tendon region, you will get to really see the stylohyoid muscle, which is going to be right about here-ish, extending into this region. So this is stylohyoid. The stylohyoid is actually going to divide around the intermediate tendon, and for the majority of its course, it will run medial and parallel to the posterior belly of the digastric. And with them being so close in location, it makes sense that this muscle is going to have a similar innervation to the posterior belly as in the cranial nerve 7. Okay, looking at an anterior view here, and a more lateral view here, let's focus on identifying the mylohyoid muscle. But before doing that, it is hard to avoid the anterior belly of the digastric. So let's get that one kind of out of the way. So there's the anterior belly here. Deep, or really it's superior to the anterior belly, is the mylohyoid muscle. So you can see the mylohyoid muscle here, and it will extend into this region. In this region, and the mylohyoid right here. It is forming, as you can see here, the bulk of the floor of the oral cavity. So if you went superior to this muscle, you are getting into portions of the oral cavity. It, like the anterior belly of the digastric muscle, will be innervated by the nerve to the mylohyoid, which is a branch of V3. Lastly, let's get a sneak peek at an extrinsic tongue muscle, which we will see in a bit more detail in the oral cavity session. And this is going to be the hyoglossus muscle. You can see a little bit of it there and a little there. You can see the lingual artery, which is right here, diving deep to the muscle. So that's going to be the hyoglossus. It is going to extend from the greater horn and body of the hyoid bone to the side of the tongue. So it makes sense that we'll see a little bit better in the oral cavity session. But you can see it here, and we did want to bring it up since it does have that relationship with the lingual artery. You can also see the mylohyoid muscle in this view, right here, with the hypoglossal nerve diving deep to that muscle. And here is that anterior belly of the digastric, which has, which you can still see the full extent of that, but that intermediate tendon has been cut in this particular dissection. So those are the muscles you need to identify in this session. Most we will review and see in different views in the upcoming oral cavity session. But since you have these in the submandibular triangle or submental triangle regions, we want you to begin getting familiar with these. Thank you all for your time, and please reach out if you have any questions.